area is area of rhombus. What rhombus is? Rhombus is a type of parallelogram in which all sides are equal and its diagonal bisect each other at right angles. That means rhombus is a parallelogram that have all the sides equal. That means AB equals to BC equals to CD equals to DA, and its diagonal, the diagonals of the rhombus ABCD are BD and AC. So these two diagonals bisect each other. That means it divide into two halves and bisect each other at an angle of 90 degree. So in this figure we have diagonals as AC and BD, and we have denoted it by D1 and D2. Now area of rhombus ABCD is given by, as we have seen in this figure, there are four triangles, but the whole diagram is divided, we can divide the whole rhombus in two triangles, that is the triangle ABC and the triangle ADC. The two triangles will make one rhombus, that is ABCD. So area of rhombus ABCD is given by area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ACD or ADC. Now, since we have already discussed about the area of triangle and it is given by half base into height. So, in triangle ABC, we have a base AC and we have a height OB. So, we can write as area of triangle ABC as half base, that means AC into height, that means OB, half AC into OB. Similarly, for triangle ACD, we have the base AC and height OD, the base AC and the height OD. So we can write as area of triangle ACD equals to half AC into OD. AC into OD. Now, as we can see that 1 by 2 and AC are common in both the areas. So we can take AC and side AC and the half as common. And what is left behind in the brackets are OB and OD. So, that means OB and OD. And OB and OD together makes BD. OB and OD together makes BD. So, we can write as, instead of writing OB plus OD, we can write as AC and into BD, and AC and BD, we have, as we have mentioned it earlier, that AC and BD are the diagonals of the rhombus. So we can write as half area of rhombus as half into diagonal 1 into diagonal. Let us take an example. The question is, the first diagonal of a rhombus is of 10 cm and the second diagonal of a rhombus is of 12 cm, and you have to find out the area of rhombus. So what we have given is first diagonal of the rhombus, that is 10 cm, and second diagonal of rhombus, that is 12 cm. Now area of rhombus is given by half into first diagonal into second diagonal. So we will put the values of first diagonal and second diagonal, that is 10 and 12. On solving this, we will get area of rhombus as 60 centimeter square. Now, the next topic is area of rectangular path. That means if we have to find the shaded region, that is the rectangular path. So, what we will do is we will use the formula area of rectangular path, which is given by area of bigger rectangle, that means the outer rectangle, minus the area of smaller rectangle, that is the inner rectangle. This is the formula we will use if we have to find out the area of rectangular path. Now, the question is, a rectangular form is 90 meters in length and 65 in width. On all the four sides, there is a path of 5 meters wide. Find the area of the path. In this question, we have given a rectangular form that is 90 meters in length and the width is 65 meters. Okay, and on all the four sides of that field form, a path of 5 meters is there. So we have to find out the area of the path. Now, as we have discussed, area of path is given by area of bigger rectangle minus area of smaller rectangle. So, area of bigger rectangle means area of A, B, C and D minus area of smaller rectangle, that is E, F, G, H. So, area of A, B, C, D means AB into CD, length into breadth, that is AB into CD. Similarly, area of EFGH is equal to, is given by EF into FG or GF. So, first we have to find out the value of AB. AB is given as EF and plus 5 centimeter from the left side and 5 meters from the right side. So on adding this, we will get AB, the length of AB as 100 meters. Similarly, the width, that is BC, that is the width of bigger rectangle. So it is 65 plus 5 meters from the upper side and from the lower side also 5 meters. That is, we will get BC as 75 meters. We have EF as 90 meters and we have GF as 65 meters. Now, we will find out the area of path. Area of path is AB into BC and we have AB as 100 and BC as 75. Similarly, area minus area of EFGH, that means EF into GF, and EF we have 90 meters and GF we have 65 meters. On solving this, we will get area of path as 1650 meter square. Now, the last topic is of mensuration. First is area of circular path. Area of circular path is similar as area of rectangular path. The basic difference is the shape of rectangular path is rectangle and circular path is circle. So, if we talk about concentric circles, so the area of circular path is given by area of bigger circle, that is area of bigger circle minus area of smaller circle. That and the area of circle is given by pi r square, and area of circular path is given by area of bigger circle minus area of small. Now the example we have taken is the radius of two concentric circles are 9 cm and 12 cm respectively. Find the area of the circular path between the two circles. So what we have given is two concentric circle. Concentric circle means the circle having the same center. So we have two circle, the smaller circle and the bigger one. We have given as the radius of smaller circle as 9 cm and the radius of bigger circle as 12 cm. Now area of circular path is given by area of bigger circle minus area of smaller circle. So radius of smaller circle is given as 9 cm, and we have denoted the smaller circle, the radius of smaller circle, by small r. Similarly, radius of bigger circle is given as 12 cm. So area of circular path, and we have denoted the radius of bigger circle as capital R. So area of circular path is given by area of bigger circle minus area of smaller circle. That means pi capital R square minus pi small r square. We will put the values of bigger circle radius and smaller circle's radius, and we will get the value as 198 cm². That is, the area of circular path is given by 198 cm². Thank you.